Hey guys, what is up? It is No Help, and welcome back to episode 97 of the Iron Man Progression, and we're doing some Chambers of Zarek. As you can see, we aren't using Void right now. We're using a little bit of the better sort of gear that we have, and I can definitely see that the fight itself went a little bit better, but I have to get used to the inventory management. As you can see, I was running out of supplies, and like I misclicked a couple of times, but definitely faster kills with the better gear, and eventually when we get Ancestral one day, we're going to have to swap it out anyways. So anyways, what was that, 304 KC for some dragon arrows and pure essence? Oh my god, could be worse. I guess KC 305 for a white light. Oh my god, that is terrible. Oh, one more hit, and purple, let's go. White light is what it is. Let's see what we get. Pure essence. Oh, there we go. Oh, I'm defeated in another white. 507 500k. I was gonna say that was like an awful chest, but dynamite is really expensive. This took me a while to learn, like sipping the overload. You kind of have to like time it really well when you're moving back and forth here so you don't mess up the cycle. The second it hits the blue square, you just click right away, and then you should be kind of back in the cycle. I remember when I was first learning this, I would just sip the overload and I would mess the cycle up, but I eventually learned the timing for it. Come on. Purple. Nah, it's a white light. Three in a row tonight. Unfortunate. 33,000 points. Dynamite again. A 600k chest. Could be worse though. Oh, that was rough. And it's a white light. I got out of cycle at the very ending, but let's just check what we got. That was awful. Some soul runes. Oh, Ohm is dead. Ohm is white. Teak planks and some sapphires. Down to 35 HP. Will we have to overload again? 12 seconds. I probably won't. Yeah, I think that's the kill. That is the kill. Purple twisted bow. Nope. 311 KC for some diamonds and some brunite. And Ohm is defeated with a white light. Ah, good god, that was awful. I might go back to Void for a bit just for some more comfort. Okay. Ooh, dead buddy, and a white light once again. 313 KC for a lot of ore, only 244k worth, but it all adds up. We are running extremely low on dragon bolts and also Solra scales, so we're gonna have to do some stuff very, very soon. But anyways, another white light, 314. Terrible chests all night, holy. We haven't gotten a purple in a very long time, so it would be nice to see something at least, because I'm probably gonna be taking about a week break from Cox right now. White light. So sad. Blood runes. So if we take a quick look at the trident, it has 1000 charges, and if we go to our Zalra skills, 1500 charges left. So we really need to go back to Zalra. Let's quickly check the collection log for Zalra here. So we've killed almost 1600. I don't know how many exactly we're gonna kill, but it would be nice to get like a unique, because I think that's 20,000 scales. That would help quite a bit. But yeah, Zalra in the next couple of weeks. And as for the dragon bolts, I believe we have we've got about 1500 of those left. Yeah, that should be enough for a very long time. Also, this is crazy. We're at 500,000 pure essence now. You get so many pure essence from doing Cox over time. And also the herbs are looking pretty good as well. So now we have to do the brutal process of making a bunch of Ring of Recoil so we can charge up the suffering, because we're going to go to do a bunch of Zalra. So yeah. I also figured I'd make a lot more of the Ruby Bolts E for when I do go back to Cox. Come on, Jagex. So this is the first trip back to Zalra. I just kind of want to mess around a little bit tonight and see if I can still remember. I only did 2 kills that trip, which is pretty bad. And we're trying out the Bofa there, actually. Not with the crystal armor, but just for fun. And Absolute Bank was made from 2 kills. Look at how the price of Zalra skills right now. They're like 200 GP each. Chaos runes, mahogany planks. 2 kills, 324k. This is going to be fun. Off to a great start. Serpentine Visage. That's what, 20,000 Zalra skills right there. We've killed 3 tonight. So I've had a fun week. Yesterday when I was at work, I go on my break, and I usually move my car on my break because the morning shift's there, and then I come in and there's so many cars in the parking lot, and basically I get there and I have to park at the very end. So usually on the first break, I will go over, move my car just to make it closer to the building so that I can get to my car easily for lunch or whatever. And yesterday I just decided not to, and some girl backed into my car and there's a massive dent in it. If I think of it, I'll throw a picture up on screen, but yeah, the week's been going great. Alright, so there's a few things to definitely talk about. So we've been at Zalra, I would say, well, it's saying on the loot tracker anyways, we're doing a 10-hour loot video for Zalra, and we're, I would say, probably 8 hours in right now with about 184 kills. Probably just get about over 200, 220, something like that, and we'll make a nice loot video, but it's already at 26 million GP, which is crazy. Zalra is dead, and Antidote's another decent drop, but there's something I wanted to show you guys. So remember how a few weeks ago, maybe about a month ago now, I was talking about how a very, very close childhood friend of mine unfortunately passed away, and I wanted to do something to kind of always have a part of him with me. So let's see if I can grab the camera here. I got a tattoo. Jesus Christ. I got a tattoo of his name right here on my arm with his birthday and his death day. But yeah, so now I've got a piece of him with me forever, which is awesome. Oh, I ran out of the teleports, so I literally have to use the fairy ring every time I come back here, and it's just kind of pissing me off. Come on, one more good hit. Okay, that was a pretty rough kill, to be completely fair. And Zalra teleports, that's very nice, that is very nice. So we can actually teleport here. Absolutely nothing, you logs and coal. Oh, it's one of those where you're out of food, so you just gotta hit. And we did end up hitting. Coconuts is good money, and I guess for farm runs in the future. Oh, look at this, the teleport, it's so freaking amazing. Now, sorry by the way with the audio in this video, something happened with some of my settings, and I kind of messed it all up, so you can hear a lot of the clicking noises in the background, and I'm going to be working on fixing that in the next little while. Just kind of frustrating how Windows sometimes makes updates, or OBS makes an update, and it just fucks everything. Now, on like a serious kind of note right now, I have really good news. Me and my girlfriend have been looking for the past, I would say, like 3 months or so, like hardcore anyways, looking for an apartment or a basement apartment or something like that that we can rent out and just kind of have a little place of our own, you know what I mean? Just kind of escape getting out of the parents' house and just, like, you know, I'm 24 years old, she's 23, and we're just looking to get out on our own. And we live in Canada, so anyone from Canada knows obviously how difficult it is, especially in Ontario, about the prices of houses, and even just renting is just freaking crazy. Yeah, so we've been on the search, but either the house sucks, doesn't have 2 parking spaces, the landlord's insane, but there's this place that we actually looked at the other day and we both really liked it. It fit like a lot of the needs that we have. It's a little expensive, but it's in the range that we were looking for anyways. And so we just like, you know, well, we thought we'd apply, wrong thing that I'm using here, range, but we thought we would apply and see what happens. And we got accepted today. So as of right now, we are moving in on September 1st, 2024. So very excited. Now, what does this really mean for my channel and everything like that? I probably won't be uploading for a couple of weeks because of the whole, Jesus Christ, I can't talk and kill something at the same time. Oh, I thought we died. Basically, I will have to move everything in, set up the internet, get everything all ready and stuff like that. But then we should be able to do a lot more content. Now, a lot of people for a very long time have been asking me, oh, it's the Jad phase. Look at this shit when we're trying to talk and kill something at the same time. We use the entire inventory of food and just get... This is going to be a drop. This is going to be a drop. It has to be, right? Because that was just terrible. Sapphires. Anyways, what I was trying to say is we'll have to move everything in. We literally have nothing. Like, I'm going to be taking my computer, my phone, some clothes. I think that's all I own. Like, to be honest, like, there's really not too much. We're gonna have to buy a lot of stuff. It's gonna be really cool because right now we actually don't really see a whole lot of each other. She lives like 30 minutes away from where I live, and she works days, I work nights, so we really only see each other on the weekends, which also means my weekends are taken up from making YouTube content or being able to do a lot of anything because I'm always with her, right? Because I don't get to see her too often. But if we live together, that's going to be a very different case. So we'll have a lot more, or I will anyways have a lot more time to kind of either be with friends or spend time with her or make a lot of content for YouTube, which is going to be exciting for me. And just the fact that we can see each other a lot more, this is kind of the whole reason we really wanted to do it. But the place is awesome, really fits, like I said, most of the needs that we both have. It's technically a two bedroom, but one's kind of, they called it a den. It's a very, very small bedroom, but I'm going to be making that the office. So a streaming room, I'm going to be making videos in there. And yes, I'm going to be starting to stream pretty regularly, at least once a week or something like that, because a lot of the content that I make now, especially with the Iron Man, each raid takes what, 45 minutes? People make fun of me for that, but so each raid takes 45 minutes and each clip's what, 5 to 10 seconds? So 10 hours is a minute of content on this right now, so it's really hard to make these progression videos unless I ramble on or do something stupid, which usually people don't like. So especially with like things like the Chambers of Zarek or even doing any bossing, any like fun content would just be a lot more fun to stream. And a lot of people for a very long time have been asking me to stream, so I definitely think it is something that I really want to do, and it'd be cool to do it in an environment that's very, very quiet. No one's gonna bother me, you know what I mean? Like, where I am right now, there's a lot of noise. There's a room right there where my sister is, and then downstairs, so it's kind of just too loud all the time to kind of stream. So that's why I only ever streamed once when I maxed the account, and I was just kind of like, hey guys, I need half an hour, you know what I mean? Also right now, I've also kind of been living the degenerate lifestyle. RuneScape player, surprise surprise, but basically I work like the nighttime job. So for the past year anyways, probably the past couple of years, I pretty much stay up the whole night, sleep through most of the day, and then work, and then do the exact same thing over and over and over again. And then by the time I see my girlfriend on the weekends, my sleeping schedule is just so messed up that I end up just sleeping half the time anyways. So hopefully when we get this place together, I will fix it a little bit, wake up in the morning, and I feel like that's probably a better time to stream content anyways, make YouTube videos. My head will be a lot more clear, you know what I mean? And then when I get off of work, I'll actually be tired instead of just like, all right, let's play RuneScape for 6 hours and then, you know, go to bed at 7 in the morning. But yeah, like I said, like when we first move in, I probably won't be uploading for a couple of weeks until we get everything in, get the whole internet situation figured out, which is, I'm really not looking forward to doing that because I'm going to try and get the fastest, best internet that I can, obviously. But I don't care the price. Just give me the internet. You know what I mean? You need it. You got to play RuneScape. You got to upload videos to YouTube. I kind of have to get the best internet possible. But I'm not looking forward to not really having it for a couple of weeks. I don't really know the longest time I've went without RuneScape in a very long time. So a couple of weeks without it's going to be a little odd. Maybe it'll I'll be able to set some goals aside and like refresh my head a little bit from just the constant grind all the time, so might be good. But obviously when I come back from that break and everything's all set up, we can start streaming, having a lot of fun. The community's been really, really good lately, and I really appreciate all of you guys, all the comments, really make my day, especially when I'm having like a terrible day. The past couple of months have been really hard for me, and some of the comments that I get just really make my day a lot better, and I really want to stream for you guys. A lot of people, like I said, have been asking me to do so, and I feel like I kind of owe it to them, you know? Well, I guess house tour, apartment tour video coming soon, gonna be really cool, but I guess for now we'll just be killing Zalra for a couple of more hours to finish off the 10 hours of Zalra video. It's been going pretty damn good, but anyways, thank you guys so much for watching the video. I will catch you in the next one. See ya later.